Hi, and welcome along to Transfer Daily. And news today coming from a Portuguese newspaper that goes by the name of A Jogo, that Arsenal are preparing to offer 30 million euros for William Carvalho. That's what Carvalho, that is what is being put out by this newspaper. The Arsenal are really, really interested in Carvalho, and they're about to offer 30 million euros to try and bring him in to Arsenal Football Club. Of course, the position of defensive midfielder is the position that every Arsenal fan knows that we need to fill. We kind of saw it again over the weekend where we're a bit lacking in that position. We've got decent players in that position in Mikel Arteta and Flamini. But if we're going to really push to win the title this season, it's a position that all Arsenal fans, including the manager, no matter how much faith he has in Arteta and Flamini, knows that he needs to fill. And, you know, Carvalho is a player. He's quite young. He's very young, and he's imposing. He's got that, in you know, that strength to play in that position, although there are some people in Portugal that reckon he's not quite ready yet for the Premier League, that it's still going to be a bit of a step up for him. But listen, he's much sought after. Manchester United have been after him for a very long time. Many of the other top clubs around Europe looking at him. And according to A Jogo, Portuguese newspaper, Arsenal about to offer 30 million euros to try and bring him in. As I've been reiterating quite a lot on this programme, there are quite a few targets, I think, for Arsenal in this position. We know about Lars Bender. We know about Kadira. We talk about it practically every day. And it's going to boil down to which one of them Arsenal decide to bring in. But A Jogo seemed convinced that it's going to be William Carvalho. I don't know. I'm still waiting to see. I still think it's going to be Kadira. I still think Kadira is the number one target. As I was saying on yesterday's show, every time Wenger's asked about it over the weekend, he's been very coy. He hasn't dismissed it, but he's just sort of skirted around it. It was interesting, actually, to hear Arsene Wenger in his press conference yesterday saying that Callum Chambers, who I thought was brilliant over the weekend in both games, for a 19-year-old kid, he looked so composed. You know, he was able to do the ugly stuff really well. He looked silky on the ball, the way he passed and everything. Sort of reminded me like a sort of a Rio Ferdinand type player. And, you know, he really, really looked a decent player. Now, Arsene Wenger, speaking at his press conference yesterday, saying that he sees his role further forward, now playing as a midfielder, playing as a central defensive midfielder. And there's a quote from Arsene Wenger. He said, about Callum Chambers, he was educated as a central defensive midfielder. Then he played in the under-19s with England. Excuse me. He played as a central defender. He played for Southampton at right back. I saw him for the first time against us, excuse me, as a right back, and I liked him. That was Arsene Wenger. So Arsene Wenger might be looking at it and thinking, well, you know what? I've found a player here that I can play as a CDM. And also, I can use him as cover, as a defender as well. Not that he's going to be the CDM, but, you know, he could be a player that could cover in that position. And I wouldn't be surprised if you see Arsene Wenger experimenting with using him in the next friendly against Manchester City in that position a bit further forward, even if it's just for, like, a half, just to see how he gets on in that position. As long as Wenger doesn't then turn around and say, yeah, this is the guy to fill it, blah, blah, blah. We need a specialist player in that position. But interesting that Arsene Wenger was saying that, you know, Callum Chambers is a player who can fill that position. And talking of the Emirates Cup, just before I go into what else I was going to say, talking of the Emirates Cup, I don't know, listen, I thought it was a decent performance by Arsenal yesterday. Obviously, not as great as the day before. Was playing a much better team yesterday. Monaco looked very, very good, very, very sharp. A goal for Falcao, which really pleased the not Monaco supporters in the crowd, but Colombian supporters. There was a load of supporters there with Colombian shirts and Colombian flags who didn't support Monaco. They just literally came to see Falcao play. and his goal really pleased them. But for Arsenal, the standout performances yesterday, Callum Chambers, I thought, was really, really good for Arsenal. The Bucci looked good, really plays far forward. He was playing like a winger at times, the Bucci, but he looked decent yesterday. And Alexis Sanchez, glimpses, obviously not fit yet. We're going to have to give him time, but we saw glimpses of what we've paid all that money for, and I think he's going to be a real, real star for Arsenal. Player that got a lot of stick yesterday, a lot of stick off of fans after the game when we were doing interviews, was Olivier Giroud. He was taken off at halftime. Arsene Wenger said, listen, it's my fault in a way. Olivier Giroud is totally not fit. Even though he's been working on his fitness during the week, he's not match fit, and he will be back sharper. I mean, a lot of fans giving Olivier Giroud a lot of stick yesterday. I think it's a bit unfair. He's his first game back. He didn't, you know, he didn't look on the pace. We're going to have to give this guy time. Listen, I've done whatever you say. He banged in 20-odd goals last season. I know there's fans who say, yeah, but none of them were against the big clubs. He didn't score against Chelsea. He didn't score against, you know, United. But he scored big goals in some big games as well. Don't forget Tottenham. And I think, you know, some of the criticism has been a bit harsh and a bit unfair. That's my opinion. It has sparked a debate, though, of do we need to buy a striker? Do we need to buy a new striker? I don't think that Arsene Wenger will buy a new striker. But a lot of fans are saying, listen, Giroud, we're not going to win the league with Giroud. We need a better quality of striker. And, of course, you know, if you're looking at striker targets out there, who is there really at the moment? Balotelli, we've seen yesterday that Liverpool have turned down a chance to sign Balotelli. So it seems like a lot of managers are looking at it and thinking, nah, it's not just worth the risk. Jackson Martinez, who's sort of been a long time, I wouldn't say target, a player that's been linked with us for a long time, who obviously would have loved to come to us. He's signed a contract extension now at Porto, so he's out of the picture. So who would that striker be? Which striker would you bring in? If, say, you know, for a lot of these people out there who don't want Olivier Giroud, who don't fancy Giroud playing in that position, who would you bring in? Which striker out there that's available would you bring in? Lukaku's out of the picture. It really narrows it down, and you don't see a lot of strikers really out there that we can bring in. That, you know, who do you think? Who's out there that you think we can bring in? Cavani recently, when he was asked about moving, said he's happy in France. Wants to prove himself at PSG, it wants to continue playing there. So again, that probably rules him out, unless you're going with a humongous deal. And is he worth it? You know, what we've seen of Cavani in the World Cup, what we saw of him last season, is he worth it? Is he, let's face it, Giroud had a better World Cup than Cavani. So listen, I'd like to know from you guys who you think a striker out there that's available. Remember the words, available. Don't just pluck strikers' names out of the air and say, we should get this and get... Strikers that you think could be available to Arsenal that we should sign. Leave them in the comments. Unfortunately, Google Hangouts, we're on to them today, by the way. But they still haven't got the comments sorted out, so I can't read them live. But you put those in the comments. Let me have a look through those. Give me the names of some strikers that are available that you think Arsenal could sign. Just before we leave, just to talk about the Thomas Vermaelen situation. Apparently, Arsenal are willing to offer him a new contract to stay, but he's not interested. He's obviously eyeing up move to either Barcelona or Manchester United. I suppose you can't blame him. He's not going to start at Arsenal. It's pretty obvious. So we need to find a defender as well, a central defender. Callum Chambers looked very good there yesterday, but we need also, I think, another defender there, maybe an experienced defender that's going to be able to come in as a foot, because that's one area you don't want to fall short. And that's the area, these are the areas where Arsenal fall down defensively. So we need to be strong in these areas. We haven't got Sané no more to cover. Vermaelen's going. We must bring in a really, really good defender who's going to be able to play as a centre-half, possibly even, you know, can do other positions across the back four. Who do you think we should bring in there? Let us know. But that's Transfer Daily today. Not a lot of rumours around. William Carvalho, that's the one central defensive midfielder. And I suppose defenders. Those are the two positions that Arsenal are hunting down right now. Who do you think we should bring in? Thanks for watching Transfer Daily today. Don't forget to check out all of our videos from over the weekend. Loads and loads of content. It was brilliant to be back on the road again, meeting all the fans. Fans had lots to say. Check out all those videos. But it was brilliant to be at the Emirates Cup. And by the way, just before I go, I nearly forgot. That referee yesterday, Martin Atkinson. I mean, I hear people talking about the other day about referees at the World Cup and how the standard. Listen, I think the refereeing standard in the Premier League can be appalling at times. And we saw yesterday another appalling decision by Martin Atkinson, giving a free kick outside the area where Akpom was clearly taken down, hacked down inside the area. The keeper should probably have got a red card as well. I mean, what planet is this referee on? And that we would have won the Emirates Cup. That would have been 1-1 if we would have buried that penalty. The refereeing standard, even in a friendly, absolutely appalling. They really got to work on the standard of referees going into the new Premier League season. And that cost us in that game yesterday. And, oh, my dear. But anyway, referees, I'll leave that to Bully. Thanks for watching Transfer Bully Transfer Daily today. And we will be back tomorrow at the same time.